aiming to choose them shots. Definitely with having Witch Time in play and just getting comboed out of the wall and stuff.
But right off the bat, we're seeing very crisp movement from Ming Ming. You know, you see his float cancels and, like, watch. See that?
Okay.
It was like, kind of like wave watching, except not as quick.
His float cancels are really good. I got to play some games with him earlier. Really clean. He uses them for mix-ups.
That was a pretty nice little punish. Mindic, no slouch either. He's definitely been practicing with Bayonetta quite a bit. Very confident in his play, for sure. Nice down air, actually. That move kills, actually. It's ridiculous. Oh, but the just throw at F smash. Nice.
Well, Ming Ming was doing the same thing as Mindic threw it out.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, so I think what happened was he actually touched that vegetable. And after he touched it, the hit stun pulled him over enough to get hit by that up smash. So really great awareness from to go for that. And also good on Indic to not fall onto that parasol, knowing that it has a hitbox that's active the entire time. Instead swinging for the back end from the side.
Is that mainly new here?
This is the first I've ever heard of it. But he seems to know what he's doing. Nope. Interesting. He definitely could have got a couple of things off of that. And Ming Ming needs all he can get, because right now he's playing from quite a heavy deficit. Kind of dropping these ladder combos in Bayonetta. Just fishing for a straight hit, trying to set up an accurate situation. And he looks like he's kind of getting it here.
Well, he has all the room to play with.
Oh yeah, nice back here.
Especially with being a
so take one going quite convincingly to Nindic there. Nindic not losing a single stock. But all the same, I'm pretty impressed with Ming Ming's overall skill and just how adept he is with Peach in general, because she's such a highly technical character. So I always have to applaud somebody who has such a good skill, someone so complicated. We're going back to Smash Bros. So that's cool.
Yeah,
starting it off right. Yeah.
Is that gonna?
Nah, he kind of messed it up. I like mixing up the with Ming's up here. Oh yeah, let's go!
What was that?
Ah, good times. Oh yeah, and Peach does stuff like that.
So. Early stock.
Nice dying at dying at three. That was
nice attempt. He's just trying to take game two back like a new weapon.
So already a very nice lead for Ming Ming here. Just tacking on some extra credit here.
And this situation is really nice because with this lead,
that was
you can really.
And with no rage. That's very unfortunate what happened though. He Ming Ming used the parasol of feed and he killed Mindic.
So good! Well, no, okay. A little bit of something is Ming Ming is a lab monster.
Oh, okay. That's like, why he knows what he's doing.
Yeah.
This is the first I've ever heard of him.
Yeah, he's been coming out periodically, but like not very often, but he definitely knows his stuff.
Oh, yeah. He's already proved that.
Three against Bayo? Like, are we getting clips? Do we get clips?
Also, we don't have chat.
I need to get that, dude.
Yeah. Come do that in a second. We're grabbing right out of that jab string.
So he's a lab monster, but do you think he has part of it playing
the actual experience? That remains to be seen. Oh, that was cute. Typically, people like that, they're really good at execution, but like they kind of slack on reads. But as you can see, that's not really an issue right now. For Ming Ming, he's doing what he knows works. All these wonderful conversions. See that dropping, picking up.
Oh!
Nindic's the worst player in the world.
Hard read. Hard read.
Did he read him like 3,000 lines ahead of it. He read him so far that like Nindic didn't even like fathom it in his mind. He didn't even know that was a possible future.
So Ming Ming taking game two, going to game three.
It's a very decisive game two as well. Killing him very early with that upbeat, and then just coming through with the fully charged F smash.
Yeah. Salt? Okay,
oh,
they might be going for it.
Yeah, I think they didn't mean to go to Smashville.
Wasn't there a limit how many times you can use it?
Unless they gentlemen, it's fine. Or no, they can only go if they gentleman, but you can't go back to a stage anymore if the other player doesn't manage it. Hence the gentleman.
Well, I imagine that an index is going to say no to Smash Bros.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to Town and City instead. So that makes me curious, or no, Ming Ming would be going to Nindix would be going to we had it.
I mean, it's good for both of them because it was
it. It makes me wonder just what Ming Ming might have made. Oh my god, it happened?
It happens! No!
Oh, you see Ming Ming kind of sharking with the up. He's trying to stay on him with that. Very impressive so far. Lots of pressure from these float cancel down airs. And just float down airs.
8% seems to be something that doesn't really phase.
Or either of these characters, honestly. I mean, maybe from a player. Ooh, wow, that was a ton of pressure. Maybe from as characters, it doesn't mean a lot, but as players, the percent is really big. But Ming Ming really is playing very fearlessly. If he had charged the up smash, maybe? Oh, just a little late.
Maybe it was sort of like kind of similar to like fastball right now.
Yeah.
Utilizing the cancel on that flow.
Nice little long stage. Maybe a punish for it back there, taking the trying for an effort as well. Witch twist. Very tough move to do. Orbiter's not going to do it. Almost one more of those moves, certainly. Very, very strong tool. Peach's strongest aerials. I thought he was just going to forward smash again, honestly. Very potent, but very simple edge guard to Ming Ming. He just stands at the ledge and he throws radishes at him.
I think he's one of those players that looks for a mistake instead of creating.
Trying to make
scenario.
The situation.
Yeah.
That could be.
Throughout this whole set, I've noticed maybe a few times we've tried on really hard threes, and you know, some of them worked and some of them didn't. So, I can imagine the edge game.
Is this up throw?
No. That's not gonna do it.
Oh, this is unfortunate. Okay. So we're back to no platforms. Nindic, knowing that he can just convert off of that first hit.
Oh, did you see that wave?
Yeah, he knew. He could have charged even, but like he didn't have those basic correct. Still, very good attempt. He's going deep for this edge guard.
I like what Ming Ming's had to do there to hit that recovery with side beat. Didn't work in the game.
Did you see that kind of cross up? Ooh, and that trade is going to cost him. He like cloak canceled back, like got up in his face, cloak canceled back, and then he side beat. Really interesting.
Really a vast knowledge of this character for sure.
Just kind of dancing around in the air. Oh, he tried to kill Sasuke again. And also very smart with that shield throw. Very smart on Ming Ming to know to drop the parasol when his back is to the ledge. Otherwise, if you have the parasol out, almost. If you have the parasol out, and your back is to the ledge, you literally can't grab it. You have to be in free fall to grab it. Or you have to. The ledge has to be in front of you. Yeah, otherwise, you can't grab it. So Ming Ming desperately needs to find this kill.
I think with Rage, maybe we could definitely pull it back.
Oh,
but at the same
sure.
time, it's one of those situations where one good back air.
Yeah, like that one.
There it is.
But that was a very fun set to watch.
I really like that. Oh, hey. You're so stupid.